Hi girls and guys, I am Shanmugha Priya from Easy Tutorials. We are going to see the lecture series on cryptography. In this first lecture series, we'll be knowing the basics of cryptography. So first, what is cryptography? So we are going to see three different terms: cryptography, cryptanalysis, and steganography. So first, what is cryptography? So cryptography is a Greek word, and the meaning for that is secret writing. So secret writing means you are writing something in a different form. So the sender, the person who is writing, will be writing the message first, and that will be converted into an unintelligible format and sent to the receiver. So this process of secret writing is called as cryptography, and the receiver will be reverting back to know what is the original message. So this process is called as cryptography. The next one is cryptanalysis. So the receiver can know the original message in an ethical way by performing some operations. So in an unethical way, with some trial and error or by guessing something, if you are trying to grab the plain text, that is called as cryptanalysis. The next one is steganography. Steganography means writing the text in a covered format. So covered form means it will not be visible. For example, the magic ink, writing with magic ink in a cloth, if you are writing with soap, it won't be visible. If you are just immersing it in the water, it will be visible. So the message is there, but directly you cannot see. It will be in cover. It will be covered in some format. If you are making some process, it will be visible. In many films, you will be seeing this steganography. These are the three basic terminologies. So next we will be seeing the other basic terminologies. So to perform cryptography, you require the original message. So that original message is called as plain text. You will be doing something and you will be converting into a coded form. So that coded form is called as ciphertext. So the process which you are doing, with some process only you are converting the original plain text into the coded ciphertext. The process of that conversion is called as either encryption or enciphering. And the reverse process is called as decryption or deciphering. So the decryption process is you are retrieving the plain text from the coded ciphertext. So to perform these two processes, encryption and decryption, you require a secret material. So that secret material is called as key. Key can be either a number or an alphabet or anything. So with that material only, you perform. So this key material will be the input to perform the encryption process, and to perform decryption, you require the key compulsorily. So these are the basic ingredients to perform cryptographic operation. Imagine you are forming or you are invent a cryptographic system. If you are doing so, cannot assume that your system is secure. You cannot say that mine is secure. No one can decrypt my encrypted text like that. You cannot bit. That is also. So how can you tell that your scheme is a computationally secure scheme? So if your cryptographic scheme is computationally secure, it must have two properties. The first property is the cost of decrypting it, or the cost of cryptanalyzing it. Without the knowledge of the sender and the receiver, if you are trying to retrieve the plain text from the ciphertext, that is called as cryptanalysis. If you are performing this cryptanalysis, you require some cost. If the cost is exceeding the value of the information, then you can tell that your scheme is computationally secure. The next one is the time required to break that cryptanalysis process must be more than the lifetime of the information. For example, I am telling a message is there to the receiver. You will be killed by 11 o'clock. You are encrypting this and sending. So when can you tell that this is computationally secure? The time to decrypt must be, cryptanalysis must be more after the 11 o'clock. That means you can tell that it is computationally secure. These are the two basic properties. The next one is, you are having many schemes. So, before knowing the scheme, you must be having two things in mind. So, these schemes will be having mathematical calculations. So, the very basic thing is you have to know about the residual class. So, residual class will be denoted by Z to the base some number, say n. So z to the base n means in the system you are performing, the numbers you use must be from 0 to n minus 1. For example, I am considering the residual class z to the base 26 means I must use numbers only from 0 to 25. That is the meaning of residual class. The next one is, in cryptography, division and modulo operation are entirely different. Division means you have to consider only the quotient, and modulo means you have to consider only the remainder. You should never go for decimal division. For example, 7 by 3 means you cannot, what is the, if it is division means 7 divided by 3 means the answer is 2. You should not go for 2 point something else. So that is division. Modulo means the remainder is 1. So like that you have to perform. So the next one is, what are the types of operation encryptions are? So the encryption can be divided into various categories. Okay, so based on type of operation, you can divide the encryption scheme into substitution and transposition. So what is substitution is, if instead of one element, if you are replacing another element, that is called as substitution. The next one is transposition. Transposition, you will be learning in your school timings, you will be having exercises like rearrange the jumbled sentence. So all the message will be there, but in a jumbled or shuffled format. So that is called as transposition. So based on the operation, you can divide the system into substitution and transposition. The next one is, based on the number of keys you use, you can divide the cryptography system into two flavors. The first one is symmetric key encryption, and second one is asymmetric key encryption. If the sender and the receiver are using only one key, that is called as symmetric key encryption. So if you are using different keys, sender is using a different key and the receiver is using a different key for encryption and decryption, that is called as asymmetric encryption. The next one is, based on the processing of the plain text, you can divide the cryptography systems into two processes. So the first one is block cipher. Block cipher means you are inputting a block of elements, more number of elements. So that is for processing, that is block cipher. One by one you are processing. At a time you are processing on only single element, means that is called as stream cipher. And this is an example or illustration of encryption system. Generally in cryptography, the sender is always called Alice. It is just a name. It is traditionally followed. Then the receiver is called Bob. And this is a typical diagram. So message in the form of plain text. This is given to an encryption algorithm. This algorithm will create a ciphertext. This algorithm makes use of a secret key that is already shared with the receiver Bob. So this ciphertext is sent via a channel. Obviously the channel is accessible to everyone, so that is why it is called as an insecure channel. And the receiver Bob finally receives the ciphertext. So this ciphertext is given to a decryption algorithm, and obviously you require a key to perform decryption and you retrieve the plain text. So this is the entire working of the cryptography. So there is an important principle called Kirchhoff's principle, or you can also call it as Kirchhoff's law. So what it is you should not assume that my cryptography system is secure. So in this, we saw five components are plain text, ciphertext, encryption method, decryption method, and key. Out of these five things, all the four things except key, that is the plain text, ciphertext, encryption algorithm, and decryption algorithm, is available to everyone. So the strength of your cryptographic system, or the security of the cryptographic system, lies only in the secret material key. So this is Kirchhoff's principle. So you should assume that all the four components, plain text, ciphertext, encryption, and decryption, is available to everyone, to the third party, to the adversaries. It is available. The only thing which is not available is the key. You must be clear with that, and this is called as Kirchhoff's principle. Then you have to know the symbol. So encryption means, in the encryption process, you will be getting the ciphertext. So that is denoted with the letter C. The encryption algorithm is denoted with the letter E to the base key. And the plain text is denoted by P. In the decryption process, you'll be getting the plain text, and the symbol is D to the base K, and C is the ciphertext. So this is the symbols you are using in the encryption and decryption. So in the next lecture, we'll be seeing the substitution techniques. Thank you.